Hello friends, welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. Myself, Mohammad Nur Hoda, Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia. Today, I will discuss the module Welfare Geography from the paper Geographical Thought that has been written by Umar Habib, Lovely Professional University, Jalandhar, Punjab. In this module, learned objective are as follows: to understand the welfare geography, to differentiate the welfare human geography and humanistic geography, and finally the conclude with the discussion of the relationship between welfare and social well-being. Introduction. Welfare geography is an approach to geography where the emphasis is spatial inequality and territorial justice. This tied up with the rise and radical geography in the early 1970s, welfare geography stresses the need to identify and explain the existence of crime, hunger, poverty, and other form of discrimination and disadvantage. Welfare geography sought to reveal the gates, what, where, and how. This early work has largely descriptive and developed the abstract formulation used in welfare economics, grounding it empirically but maintaining the use of algebraic representation. It provides a basic for evolution. Current welfare configuration regarding who gets what, where, and how could be judged against the alternatives. This preoccupation worth description eventually aimed to match and then suspended by work on the process through which inequalities is shaped. Marxist economics replaced neoclassical economics as a basis of for its illustration analysis, which takes place at two different levels. The first involved understanding how the whole social economics and political system function and teasing out universal tendencies in the case of capitalism. In label of analyzing the reveals that inequality is in endemic, uneven development is the special imprint, the geographical result of the restlessness of the capitalism as a system. The second level of explanation attend to the detail of particular social, economic, and political system. For example, how housing policies under capitalism advantage some people in some place and disadvantage other people in other place. The analysis of the politics behind these policies are recently been strengthened as part of renewed interest in relationship between social justice and the state. Accompanying an attention to the restructure of the welfare state, which characterize much of this recent work said by the Pank in 2001, and have been endeavor to theorize a relation ethics of care. A illustration of feminist theory, this work seeks to uncover the social relation and behind construction of care and justice, understanding politics as an integral part of a part in the daily deeds. The emphasis is on connection and relation rather than the difference between category such as private and public, state and market. Welfare geography focus on the connection between the spatial variation of need and a structure of a provision in creation of geographic of welfare, a rather late arrival of welfare approach in humanities and social sciences, and particularly in geography, as several political, historical, psychological reasons, that is the Vietnam War, crime exploitation, environmental degradation, the manifestation of social, political, and economic injustice through these crises in cities and towns led to group of social scientists to come up with new ideas that promote the radical approach, especially with geography. The issue of distribution was taking new urgency before the dawn of quantitative revolution. Geography, like all the other main sister discipline from the humanities and arts, face many philosophical and methodological problems. Geography did not progress as well regulate discipline. In recent years, geographers have, however, adopted new strategies by restructuring their sources of study, their courses of study, and design the theme around the contemporary issues like socio-economic development, rural studies, making the subject a primary source of awareness of local surrounding and regional milieu. During the last 5 decades, the subject matter of geography has experienced immense change in the subject matter, philosophy and methodology. The issues of primary concern on which the geographer concentrating nowadays, including hunger, poverty, racial discrimination, population, environmental pollution and social inequalities or injustice, and use the overuse of depleting resources, etc. Some of the leading work and issues which have been useful in the public policy making are black ghettos, geography of crime and geography of social well-being, the quantitative revolution of the 1960s infused a vigor into geography, which was vastly essential for the in-depth and comprehensive analysis required in any public context, and the formulation of proposal of public policy. Scientific revolution paved it way in geography in the early 1960s. The pragmatists introduced the use of scientific method for finding solution to the problem faced by human being. It is with the intent that a scholar like David M. Smith have embraced the welfare approach while debating the problem, prospect and future scenario of human geography. The welfare approach is a geography has been defined differently by some eminent scholar of geography. Michan was of the view that, according to Michan, the theoretical welfare geography is that branch of study which endeavor to formulate position by which we may be able to rank on the scale of better and worse alternative in the geographical situation open to societies. While Nath has defined welfare geography as that areas of geographical studies where we can study the possible impact of different geographical policies for well-being of the society. In the special context, Smith defined welfare geography as the study of who gets what and where how. The geographer whose prime concern are problem of society and are trying to formulate for realistic plan for public policies by giving the description and explanation of phenomena. Through such analysis, they evaluate their plans and suggest suitable strategies for balanced development of the country. The explanation involves the empirical identification of territorial level of human development and human condition. This is more an instantaneous research area which astonishingly little work has been done in India and other developing countries as well as developed countries. Explanation cover the how it evolved it identifying the cause and effect relationship link among the different activities undertaken in societies as they contribute in determining who get what and where. This is where the analyzing of the economic, demographic and social pattern mentioned above logically fit into the welfare structure, geographical distance, and then an areas of understanding means that some people will be enjoying the better place to for advantage or disadvantage, whether the structure is a road, railways, hospital, schools, theater, communities hall, cinema, park or recreational places. Therefore, location decision and comprehensive plan for a special location, a special location of resources must be made with the almost care and dedication. If the benefit and penalties are found to be proportional among the population in a more or less predictable and reasonable manner, in such public policies decision making, geographer role become authoritative and they have the necessary expertise in the spatio-temporal analysis of any such phenomena. Spatial allocation problem are related to the identification of priority areas, priority areas, planning routes and location of factories or other sources of employment, the spatial arrangement of facilities providing medical care, housing complexes, shopping center, allocation of land for different urban and recreational usage. Such of these decision could be made in some way, and every decision can be a different influence. Geographer by their expertise can build up more sophisticated knowledge and model of the process of development. This involves unscrambling and complex network of economic, social and cultural relationship, and also the ecological relationship in equilibrium way, so easily disturbed by ill-conceived developmental project. Geographer by sharing out analyzing and synthesizing of a space can contribute successfully, meaningfully and more efficiently to the formation of policies for the public poverty. In developing countries, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Brazil, there is a relatively a high degree of internal inequalities. On the other hand, in the third world nation, wealth and power and other facilities of public interest are still largely in the hands of urban entities or big landlord. In the India, more than 50% of population is still below the poverty line. On the contrary, over 50% of the total national assets are in the hands of the only dozens of families. Moreover, in India, most of the economic activities are concentrated in metropolitan core, although still more than 70% of the total population is residing in the rural areas. The urban based industrial and social infrastructure policies adopted by planner is widening the already wide gap on the one hand between the rich and the poor, and contrary between the urban and rural population. The highly advanced and developed countries like USA, Russia and Australia and Japan also have spatial disparities in level of human development. In the United States, the overall material standard of living is higher than anywhere else in the world. Millions of Americans, especially Negroes, live in poverty and social denial in ghettos. In many parts of the rural south of USA, like Texas, Georgia, the living condition of some people are really bad in condition, anywhere in the African continent. In these ghettos, the rate of crime like drugs, addiction is very high. The preservation of widespread poverty in American slums, the most of affluent societies in the world, is a paradox which underlines the failure of economic growth under the capitalist system to uplift the lives of all people to a current standard of decency. In 1976, according to the US Census Bureau, about 12% of Americans were below poverty line. One of the opinions put forward by the capitalist for existing regional, inter-regional and intra-regional disparities is that human beings are not born equal and hence they cannot be equal in their societies. This situation gets further serious if the social, political and economic organization is intended or formed with the urban biased or rich people centered policies. This planner with the help of geographer can construct a general social amenities which can be benefited all section of societies. Geographers, however, cannot be the cure for all the ill inequalities and socio-economic imbalance that are persistent. Geographer can analyze the spatial dimension of environmental problem, natural hazard, and more particularly, they know how to handle, analyze, and how to handle, analyze, and interpret spatially distributed data. This consciousness of and facilities of tracking the spatial dimension, which is a major component of all problem of resources and environmental management, is something not provided by those in other discipline and have a tendency to be overlooked if a geographer does not arrange it. A welfare society need better sharing of communities, better distribution of communities, and better of means of manufacturing among individuals and places. All these things are more easily attainable if geographers who are dealing with the man-environment interface and elaborate the spatial distribution of phenomena are actively involved in procedure of planning and formulation of public policies are different level of development of the nation. The local, regional and national, international level, in countries like Sweden, the Netherlands, France, Norway, Israel, Denmark, USSR, Australia and New Zealand, where geographer in collaboration with the scholars and scientists of other fields to design public policies which is the effective and beneficial and reaching all section of societies, these policies a judicial way. Similarly, a geographer in India can also provide practical proposal for solving the various infrastructural problem that are caused by rapid increasing population. Difference between welfare human geography and humanistic geography. By their effort, geographer can bring the causal relationship between inequalities arising between the spatial organization of society and social structure. Public policies about restructuring and rearrangement can be designed properly by the experts through the planning. Planning is a necessary thing in any policies. These experts who have expertise in man and environment relations and spatial analysis of phenomena. For this purpose, geographer will have to emphasize on themselves through their applied and practical researches. Although human geography has appeared from earth sciences and has persistent link with the physical geography. Hitherto, the core aim of the particular branch of knowledge is examining the various problems of different social groups about their environment. At present, especially after the 1960s, the geographer have adopted very welfare approach as in planning process, go to the approaches for the study of human behavior. Welfare approach in fact emerged as a response of quantitative revolution, spatial sciences, positivism and model building, which was thought to be a unsatisfactory concern with contemporary glitches of human societies. In 1970s saw a chiefly redirection of human geography in the direction of welfare issues such as hunger, deprivation, malnutrition, poverty, crime, distribution of income, assets and access to social service. This correspondent to major change in the social concern from constant economic condition of development or progress or wider aspect of the quality of life, a spatial distribution of phenomena and distributional issues have presumed new importance in the present era to slow economic growth. For in this condition, policies of distribution in favor of the poor or socially deprived can be investigated only at the expense of the rich or better of member of the societies. This also known as the Pareto optimality condition, a condition in which it is not possible to make some people rich without making other poor. The Pareto model assume that one society has touched the edge of the production possibilities, that is, if there is no more growth, the poor cannot be made rich unless at the expense of the rich. The basic emphasis of the welfare approach is who get what, where and how. The who refer to the population of the area under review, in which a city, region, country or entire world comes, subdivide into the groups by caste, class, races and other relevant characteristics like religion. The what refers to the different good and bad and bads enjoyed or tolerant by the population in form of services, commodities, social relationship, environmental quality and so on. The where reflect the fact that living standards differ according to the place of residence. The how refers to the procedure whereby the observed differences arises. The initial task posed by the welfare approach is descriptive. The present state of society concerning the fact that who get what, where, may be signifies it by the extension of abstract interpretation of welfare economics, and hence the practical objective is to be give these empirical substances to the people in a specially disaggregated society. The general level of welfare may be written as, according to the Dictionary of Human Geography edited by Johnston in 1994, well stated that in a special disaggregated society, the general level of welfare may be written as this form, where S is a level of living, where W welfare is equal to the F is denote to the function and S is a denote to the social well-being in a sets of regional subdivision. In other words, it can be said that welfare is the function for the distribution of goods and bads among the different group of people as defined by the area of residence. Social well-being may be defined regarding what people get as follows, where X denoted the quantity of the goods and bads consume or experience. Social well-being may be expressed regarding the distribution within the area of the question. In this equation, we can show that the S is equal to F on under bracket U1 or UK, where U is a level of well-being, that means utility or satisfaction of each of the each of the K population subgroup, which is a subgroup. In all the above expression, the terms may be weighted differentially and joined according to any function to denote the combination of territorial or regional level of well-being, goods and bads, that maximize the objective function W, any welfare or societies. For identifying a discrepancy in the territorial distribution of development of social indicator is a great importance. Such indicator may be as follows: housing, income, education, income, education, employment, social order or social participation, etc. Social participation, etc. This welfare approach found neoclassical economics as the least suitable one to explain the social inequalities. The Marxian economics provide a useful tools for analyzing social problems such as housing, income, education, employment, because capitalism has an inherent tendency to create disparity. The second level of explanation deals with the process of how a specific element of a social, political, economic system operates. This is given by the D.M. Smith in 1977. In his Human Geography, a welfare approach first suggested the approaches which later amalgamate with other approaches of geography dealing with the issue of inequalities, the issue dealt with by welfare geography, demand an interdisciplinary approach of the highest order. Moreover, in an rapidly changing era of globalization, where the developing South Eastern deprive vice versa the advanced north areas of the country, there has been a transformed interest in welfare geography, welfare and social well-being. The welfare geography approaches deals with the issues related to the inequalities and injustice. The approach grew up as a reaction to the quantitative and the model building tradition of the 1960s. In 1970s, there was a major redirection of human geography towards the social problem. That is a number of in social problem in this direction. That is a poverty, hunger, crime, racial discrimination, access to health, education. The issue such as the distribution of fruit, of economic development received attention mainly as a result of the dramatic socio-political changes in Eastern Europe. Dramatic socio-economic changes, political changes in Eastern Europe and South Africa. Therefore, the basic emphasis of welfare geography is on who gets what, where, and how. The who suggests the population of an area under review, and the what refer to the various facilities and handicaps enjoy and endure by the population in form of services, commodities, social relationships, and the where refer to the differing living standard in different areas. Moreover, how reflect the process by which the observed differences arises. The empirical identification of inequalities in traditional in territorial distribution developing a social indicator. These may combine particular elements of social well-being in a composite manner, condition that may be include an income, wealth, and employment, housing, environmental quality, health, education, social order. These all are the same as under the social order, with absence of crime, deviation, and other threats of social stability and security, social participation, recreation, and leisure. Alternatively, the focus may be on individual aspect of social well-being. There's a core area of the study of welfare geography is the social well-being, such as inequalities in areas of access to health care, or the differential experience of the nuisance, such as noise, air pollution, and so on. Descriptive research of this kind is justified because it provided information on aspects of life neglected in geography. It also provides a basic or evolution, evolution where the existing state is judged against the alternative, in which the predicted the planned way according to some criteria of welfare improvement. Thus, the impact of alternative plan and for facility, location of closure hospital, location of closure of the houses like hospital, schools, recreation park could be judged by the taste of which would most equally. The benefits such as access to health care among the population of various subdivision of area under review. This raises the question of rules of distribution on justice and the manner in which they are applied in the political process. Although originally proposed as an alternative framework for human geography, the welfare geography has in that condition now been merged with the other line of inquiry within the geography directed towards the fundamental problem of inequality. Implicit in welfare geography is a recognition that the issues of question extend beyond the limits of single discipline and in fact render disciplinary boundaries increasingly irrelevant. The welfare approach logically required a holistic social perspective. In other words, we can say that in order to achieve the welfare target, geographers are attacking social problem and exploring the closes of socio-economic backwardness, environmental pollution, and uneven level of development in a given physical setting. Now, the main objective of geographical teaching are research in to train the student in the analysis of phenomena so that they can take up a subsequently problem of a society as a field that there is a research and investigation, thereby helping the locals, states, national administrations. Problems are being tackled with the approaches ranging from positive or normative, from radicalism to humanism, and from idealism to realism. In brief, geographers are increasingly concerning themselves with the problem of society, condition of mankind, economic inequalities, social justice, and environmental pollution, for reduction of regional inequalities and for the improvement of the quality of life of a human being in the living society. The main concern of the geographer is with that should be the spatial distribution of phenomena instead of with what it is now. It is in this context that the spatial inequalities in the social amenities and living standard is investigated by the geographer is a core area of the researcher to trace the origin of disparities rather than the condemn injustice. The geographer who are mainly concerned with the problem of society and trying to formulate pragmatic proposal or public policies clarify the description and explanation of the phenomena which is going on the basis of such analysis. They evaluate their plan and prescribe suitable strategies for balanced development of society. Description involves the empirical identification, the territorial level of human well-being, that is the human condition. This is a major and immediate research area in which surprisingly little work has been done in India and the other developing countries. Thank you.